Hello children, I'm back with the third part of the lesson, The Best Christmas Present in the World. So far you've read that the writer finds a letter from a secret drawer of the roll top desk that he purchases from a junk shop. The letter was written by Jim, who was leading the English army in the war with Germans. He wrote to his wife Connie about a wonderful experience that how soldiers from both the sides celebrated Christmas amidst war. Now, what does the writer do with the letter? Let's read in the third part of the lesson. लेखक को कबाड़ी की दुकान से खरीदे हुए डेस्क में से एक पत्र मिलता है, जो कि जिम ने अपनी पत्नी कॉनी को 1914 में लिखा था। वह अंग्रेजी सेना का एक सैनिक था और वह जर्मनी सेना के साथ युद्ध में तैनात था। पत्र में वह अपनी पत्नी को लिखता है कि कैसे दोनों तरफ के सैनिकों ने युद्ध के दौरान क्रिसमस मनाया। अब लेखक इस पत्र का क्या करता है? आइए जानें। So children, let's start reading the chapter. I folded the letter again and slipped it carefully back into its envelope. I kept awake all night. By morning, I knew what I had to do. I drove into Bridport, just a few miles away. I asked a boy walking his dog where Copper Beaches was. House number 12 turned out to be nothing but a burned out shell, the roof gaping, the windows boarded up. I knocked at the house next door and asked if anyone knew the whereabouts of a Mrs. McPherson. Oh yes, said the old man in his slippers. He knew her well. A lovely old lady, he told me, a bit muddle-headed, but at her age, she was entitled to be, wasn't she? 101 years old. She had been in the house when it caught fire. No one really knew how the fire had started, but it could well have been candles. She used candles rather than electricity because she always thought electricity was too expensive. The fireman had got her out just in time. She was in a nursing home now, he told me. Burlington House on the Dorchester Road on the other side of the town. Now the explanation. After reading the letter, the writer puts it back. He doesn't sleep the whole night. You can see children in the picture. He's wide awake. In the morning, he reaches at the address given in the letter, only to find the house completely burnt. He inquires about Mrs. McPherson from one of the neighbors, who tells him about how the house had got burnt, and also that at the moment Mrs. McPherson was at a nursing home on the Dorchester Road. Aur ab Hindi mein. Lekhak patr padhkar use band kar deta hai, vah sari raat jaagta rehta hai. सुबह होते ही वह पत्र पर लिखे हुए एड्रेस पर पहुंचता है और वहां पहुंचकर वह देखता है कि घर पूरी तरह से जल चुका है। वह साथ वाले घर का दरवाजा खटखटाता है और मिसेस मैकफर्सन के बारे में पूछता है। पड़ोसी उसे मिसेस मैकफर्सन के बारे में बहुत सी चीजें बताता है और वह यह भी बताता है कि उनके घर में आग लग गई थी और उस समय वह अंदर ही थी, पर उन्हें समय पर निकाल लिया गया और इस समय वह शहर के दूसरी ओर डॉर्चेस्टर रोड पर स्थित बर्लिंगटन हाउस नाम के एक नर्सिंग होम में है। नाउ लेट्स रीड आउट द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ। आई फाउंड बर्लिंगटन हाउस नर्सिंग होम इजीली इनफ। देयर वर पेपर चेन्स अप इन द हॉलवे एंड अ लाइटेड क्रिसमस ट्री स्टूड इन द कॉर्नर विद अ लॉपसाइडेड एंगल ऑन टॉप। आई सेड आई वाज अ फ्रेंड कम टू विजिट मिसेस मैकफर्सन टू ब्रिंग हर अ क्रिसमस प्रेजेंट। I could see through into the dining room where everyone was wearing a paper hat and singing. The matron had a hat on too and seemed happy enough to see me. She even offered me a mince pie. She walked me along the corridor. Mrs. McPherson is not in with the others, she told me. She is rather confused today, so we thought it best if she had a good rest. She has no family, you know, no one visits, so I'm sure she'll be only too pleased to see you. Now the explanation. The writer finds the nursing home easily he sees that it is decorated for Christmas and the celebrations are going on there. The matron tells the writer that Mrs. McPherson doesn't like to be with everyone, and today she isn't feeling good, so she's taking rest. लेखक नर्सिंग होम पहुंचकर देखता है कि वहां क्रिसमस की पार्टी चल रही है। मैट्रन उसे बताती है कि मिसेस मैकफर्सन लोगों से दूर ही रहती हैं और आज वह कुछ ठीक महसूस नहीं कर रही हैं, इसलिए आराम कर रही हैं। वह यह भी कहती है कि वह उसे देखकर यानी लेखक को देखकर खुश हो जाएंगी क्योंकि उनसे मिलने कभी कोई नहीं आता। Now let's read further. She took me into a conservatory with wicker chairs and potted plants all around and left me. The old lady was sitting in a wheelchair, her hands folded in her lap. She had silver white hair pinned into a wispy bun. She was gazing out at the garden. Hello, I said. She turned and looked up at me vacantly. Happy Christmas, Connie, I went on. I found this. I think it's yours. As I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. That was the moment her eyes lit up with recognition and her face became suffused with a sudden glow of happiness. I explained about the desk, about how I had found it, but I don't think she was listening. For a while she said nothing but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Here the writer tells us that the matron takes him to Mrs. McPherson. She was sitting on a wheelchair with folded hands. She was looking at the garden. The writer greets her and shows her the letter. On seeing the letter, a sudden glow of happiness came upon her face, but she said nothing. She just patted the letter gently. लेखक बताता है कि मैट्रन उसे मिसेस मैकफर्सन के पास ले गई। वह व्हीलचेयर पर बैठी बागीचे की ओर देख रही थी। लेखक उसे क्रिसमस की शुभकामनाएं देता है और टीन का डिब्बा खोलकर उसे देने के लिए आगे करता है। पत्र को देखकर मिसेस मैकफर्सन के चेहरे पर एक चमक आ जाती है। लेखक उसे सारी बात बताता है कि यह डिब्बा उसे कैसे मिला, पर वह न तो कुछ बोलती है और न ही कुछ सुनती है, बस हाथ से उस पत्र को सहलाने लगती है। Now let's read the last two paragraph of the lesson, children. Suddenly she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. You told me you'd come home by Christmas, dearest, she said, and here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you're back. You can read it to me yourself. Would you do that for me, Jim, dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I'd love that so much. And then perhaps we'll have some tea. I've made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. Here the writer further tells us that Mrs. McPherson holds his hand and kisses him, taking him to be her husband, Mr. McPherson. She thinks that Jim has kept his promise of returning on Christmas, and this way he has given her the best Christmas present of the world. In other words, we can say that she is grown so old waiting for her loving husband that she mistakes the writer to be her husband. लेखक बताता है कि मिसेस मैकफर्सन उसे अपना हस्बैंड जिम समझ लेती है और उसे जिम समझकर उसे पकड़ लेती है, उसका हाथ पकड़ लेती है। उसे लगता है कि उसके पति ने अपना क्रिसमस पर वापस आने का वादा पूरा कर दिया है और यह उसके लिए दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा क्रिसमस गिफ्ट है। आपने देखा बच्चों, मिसेस मैकफर्सन अपने पति का इंतजार करते हुए इतनी बूढ़ी हो चुकी हैं कि वह लेखक को ही अपना पति समझ लेती हैं। बच्चों, थी ना यह एक दिल को छू देने वाली कहानी। इसमें हमने देखा कि युद्ध की वजह से कितने परिवार बिखर जाते हैं, कितनी जिंदगियां तबाह हो जाती हैं। विद दिस वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ द लेसन। आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड इट वेल एंड लाइक्ड इट टू। Wasn't it a touching story, children? That's all for now. I'll be back with some more lessons. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.